Since the early 1980s, golden kernels of corn have been made into ethanol fuel for cars, for trucks, and buses. The industry started with a single plant producing a few hundred thousand gallons of ethanol a year, and it took off from there. By 2013, more than 200 plants in the U.S. were producing close to 14 billion gallons of ethanol from corn grain annually. Ethanol is a green fuel. It burns clean. And unlike oil, a fossil fuel, ethanol is renewable because it's made from corn that's grown every year across the country. Ethanol can also be made from sugarcane and from other types of plant matter. The technology for ethanol production has improved dramatically over the years. Now, companies are moving into ethanol production from other sources, specifically plant residue. One of the biggest sources of residue is corn stover, the plant stems, stalks, leaves, and cobs that remain after corn grain has been harvested. Crop residue for ethanol is now a new crop for farmers. It provides additional revenue with minimal input costs. It doesn't require additional planting, and it's easy to harvest with large baling equipment. Minimal nutrients are removed when about a quarter of the residue on a field is used. Near Emmitsburg, Iowa, in the heart of corn country, there's a huge plant that processes corn stover into ethanol. It's owned by Poet Biorefining of South Dakota and Royal DSM, a European company. The facility is named Project Liberty because of its goal to produce renewable fuel from plant biomass. At full capacity, it will produce 20 to 25 million gallons of ethanol fuel a year. The fuel is made from corn stover that's packed into large bales that weigh 1,000 to 1,500 pounds each. Bales are produced on farm fields within a 30 to 40 mile radius of Emmitsburg. They're delivered to the plant for processing. Producing a liquid fuel from corn residue dry matter rather than corn kernels isn't easy. Company scientists have spent more than 10 years designing and developing the processes needed to make it happen. That research has involved many elements of science, technology, engineering, and math. One of the major hurdles to overcome is the fact that a large percentage of biomass energy is tied up in complex chains of polymers. It's in the form of lignin, pectin, cellulose, and hemicellulose. These are an integral part of plant cell walls, moving water and nutrients and providing the strength to support plant development. Before the stover can be fermented to make fuel, it has to be physically ground into small pieces. Then those dry matter pieces are treated with enzymes, so they break down into simple sugars, such as glucose. Microorganisms are then used to ferment the sugars into ethanol. Doing this requires several steps and a lot of complicated processing equipment. That's why the cellulosic ethanol plant in Emmitsburg is a complex maze. You see tanks and tubes, pumps and pipes, and computerized controls. The output is tested at several stages in the quality control laboratory. Technicians use sophisticated testing equipment. All of this is on the cutting edge of industrial technology. This facility and several others like it around the world may someday produce several billion gallons of cellulosic ethanol every year. That's a drop in the bucket of our total fuel use, but it's a step in the right direction. It's sustainable technology that uses plant residue as a new source of fuel, a source that helps replace disappearing fossil oil reserves. And that's a breath of fresh air for all of us.